Okay, then we thank you for you joining this session. And hold on. Okay, today is my topic is about the GPTHound. Maybe you will see this title, you will connect to the Bloodhound. Yes, yes. We writing a side project for the when we do the active directory analysis. We want to write an extension for the Bloodhound and to help us reduce the human error in the analyzing process. But our this project position is based on the AD security assistance, not a virtual analyzer. And we will show why this assistant not analyzed. Quick introduce about myself. I'm a senior researcher at Sitecraft, and I also a co-founder at UCC Hacker, which is a Taiwan cybersecurity community. And I also speak at the Black Hat USA, HITCON, Code Blue, HITB. And I'm also focused on the AD and the Windows security. Along representing the outline of our talk, first, we will introduce about the current language model in the cybersecurity and the current active directory situation and the analyze method, what we got like the Bloodhound, Pink Castle, something like this. And we will share about how we leverage the language model in the active directory security. And we need to determine the capability of the language model and to see what can language model help us in this process. And the final part, we will have some share the detailed design and have a full demo about our project. Let's move on. So AI or language model is a very hot topic in the recent months or year. How about the language model in current cybersecurity? If you are familiar with some news or some trend, you will see there's a rating related language model like the phishing, like warn GPT or fraud GPT. It can write the phishing mail. And also there's a bird GPT can help you find the vulnerability. And also there's a pentest GPT can auto execute the attack command. For the bulleting side, there's much about related to the expand the report or expand the alert. So there is some security vendor say they have a language model integrated with their AI integrated with their product. Yeah, basically it's just interpret the alert or report. And also there's some tool with IDA Pro, they can help you do the malware analysis like deobfuscation or just transfer the hex code to some binary code to the C code, something like this. You can use this kind of situation for help you to do the in the cybersecurity region. So basically, because it's a really hot topic, so I want to use a language model. So we choose Active Directory as our target, and why is Active Directory security? Because any misconfiguration might can take over an entire domain, and compromise Active Directory or domain controller means compromise the whole enterprise. And still has a more new attack methods are still being found. So that's why we choose Active Directory security. And because the language model also use a lot of online resources, so ChatGPT know a lot about what is Active Directory. So we don't need to retrain, what is domain controller? What is RDC? What is Kerberos? He already been training to read this data. So we only need to do is teach him about what is security. So currently booting for the AD security practice, there's two direction. The first direction is about the most common one is a facilitation of the attack path, like the Bloodhound, AD lens, or forest story, like something like this. Because there are a lot of paths about a lot of attack paths, maybe you cannot solve in the one investigation. So then you need to prioritize the issue and review the security configuration. So there's some Bloodhound. It's a extended project based on the Bloodhound. And also Pinkcast, so then the YD is based on, is prioritizing and check security configuration. And today we will focus on the attack path visualization. So, it's a screenshot from the Bloodhound. And you can see if you are analyzing the entire Active Directory, there's a lot of attack paths. So we need to do something like, we need to find this attack path should be exist or not, should be removed. So analysts need to do these following things, like find the attack path to the critical object, like to the tier 0 object. And figure out this attack path should be exist or should be removed. And find the vulnerability scan, like Kerberosting, plain text password in description, or ADCS misconfiguration, something like this. And then finally, we will summarize this and write a report. But this human analyst, they say they will do this kind of job when they are doing the analyst thing. But we must understand the task under the by analyst during the processing. Because there's a previous, the slide is too general, so we can separate these to the four major tasks. If you want to find the attack path to the critical object, you might be want to write a generate a query to search your attack path. If you want to find a vulnerability setting, you also need to write a query to search your attack path. And figure out this attack path should not exist because it's a kind of you need to determine, it's only one object has this specific permission. This should be a service account or it should not be, has this permission. So we need to figure out to do the clustering to check does any account has a similar permission like this object. And then finally we will summarize the report. So we need to write a report. We need to write about what is a attack path impact and give our customer to have some recommendation or remediation strategy. So based on this, we want to use a language model to help us to write the query. So we want to let this language model can understand what the query can for the Bloodhound. And the second is access classification to group the object. So there's a lot of enterprise, they will write some description in their computer object or user object. Say, this access code, maybe is which year or the owner is who, something like this, or ticket number. So we can identify by the permission and the description. We will introduce later on. And the search sensitive information is the interesting part for the language model. And we will show you because language, for our human, I only know the English and the Chinese. So with the language model, he can identify different languages. It also helps us to can find some interesting data. And the expand attack path and remediation, we will show you how we build this on this project. So talk about our system design, because this is a cybersecurity conference. So I need to quick briefing about what the core module we use. It's a language chain. Full title is a language chain. Actually, it's a modern framework combined a different language model, like this can combine the ChatGPT, Llama 2, something like this. And it support a lot of about anything you need to when you develop a language model application, like a prompt template, memory, or index or agent. And we will show you how the language model manipulate the CS file or Neo4j database. So we use the language as our whole project core brand. So here is we use a next-gen with GPT 3.5 as a core brain. And we will tell ChatGPT, say, oh, you have a following task and this tool can use. And this tool is just what previously mentioned. And this task will connect to the different component, like the Neo4j connect. You can execute the command and connect to the Bloodhound database to execute, pull out the data from the Bloodhound database and, we will give a schema to him to let him know, oh, there was a, what the current schema we have. So he can more specific generate the query. And for CS operator, we have the clustering results CSV. We will introduce later. We will show you how this looks like. And then we have our own CSV file about the attack expand and the instrumentation. So first, we deep dive the generate query to search attackers. Here's a concern question. You can think about it. It's a review. Want to write a cyber query or Neo4j query in the Bloodhound. Find out which user might under the Kerberosting attack. You might need to know something. What is Kerberos attack? So you need to do the following things. Is what is Kerberosting attack? Fortunately, the ChatGPT already know is what is Kerberosting. And it only the thing he does, ChatGPT doesn't know is, he doesn't know what is a Bloodhound, or doesn't know the Bloodhound language, schema, something like this. And the Kerberosting is an attack technique about talking Kerberos service ticket to extract the password. So it's required user has a service principal name. And we need to do a Bloodhound schema and the cyber query language. So that's all. So if you without any training to the ChatGPT, we ask a question about, oh, you generate a cyber query. I want all user object has SPN. Or I already tell him, well, the object with SPN. But the final answer is, he just gave me the cyber query doesn't work in the Bloodhound because the ChatGPT not familiar with the Bloodhound. Basically, his cyber query is very general, but it's correct. But because Neo4j database don't have less properties, so that's why it's not working. So the solution is very simple. We use in the language chain they have a prompt template. So prompt template you can write a prompt template and input anything you want and combine them together. So we get the information from the Neo4j database to get the schema to let the ChatGPT know. So this property is boolean value or its property is hex or number, something like this. And the ChatGPT will input a user question and combine them together and output the information. And the final, there's an important part is extract the cyber query because sometimes ChatGPT will give you some criteria you don't want. So you will say, my limitation because I'm a language model or something like this is not the text we don't want. So we will filter out the result. So based on the, prompt template, as there's some major point I want to share is about the we need to take care about like the upcase, lowercase, or no value. Because for human, maybe lowercase Jiang and all upcase Jiang is a same object. But for the Neo4j or for ChatGPT, they think they are different. So we must take them know, oh, you need to consider all possibility about the lowercase and uppercase. And because the Neo4j database doesn't support the Bloodhound database, doesn't support the advanced cyber query, so only use the match and where to filter out the data and solve a less limitation. And finally, it's use a schema with a profile to reduce the heap profile and the relationship or the property that doesn't exist. So with this data, we ask the same question. We use a more general. We ask, I want all user object might be collaborating attack. Okay. So he just provide the information like, he know collaborating need a SPN. So he's just pick a property which is called SPN and, filter another admin count is true. So basically, that's why we call this assistant, not a virtual analysis. Because in human analysis, we don't want you filter con, admin con is true. That's what we don't want, but he gives it to us. So we still need to human to adjust this query. And the second part is cluster, user, and host. So our goal is giving the user or the computer object and find the relate object. Like maybe find the most similar account with the user Jiang. And then there's a challenge is what's the definition of the similar of this content. So here's our internal training say, how to identify this object might be relate or similar. We provide a name, description name, we also call the DNN and the group list. Just take a 10 seconds, maybe you can figure out what's possible is this object relate. Okay, and I will highlight the result. First, let's expand the description field. It's a well, in the well organization enterprise, they often include some information or project name or owner name in the description. So you can see there's some username and behind and after this is a notebook or PC, something like this. So you can identify maybe this computer owner is this guy and the DNN is all under the same organization unit. They are all computer and John and Stephen Wang is all the users. And the group list they are in under the same group list. But this is a very basic similarity. So we summarize it up to the classification rule based on its permission. So based on the same permission, we will guess the each object might be similar. And also the organization, because this is a very important part is if the all the object under the same organization, maybe they are enterprise will use the department or the country or the location as their organization unit. So for example, there's Taiwan, Taipei, IT department. Something like this, they will create a organization unit and put an AD object under this OU. And also description, just like I mentioned about, is beside the password, sometimes we will contain a ticket number or SS code, something like this. So we can clustering this kind of the data. So basically our previous idea is first idea pop up is use ChatGPT embedding. So user embedding, just in case you don't know what's embedding, is you can put the simply is you can put the this kind of a data or string into this graph, and every node is maybe represent a user or computer object. So basically, we want, and after you put all the object into this node, and you can cluster fighting the, It's one group, one cluster, and the second, third, and therefore this can be a different color. So basically is we want to use ChatGPT to embedding and do the clustering. But after our discussion with our AI expert, he say you don't know this kind of it's too complicated. Just a very simple traditional clustering can do it as well. So actually we don't use GPT embedding in this part is module. We just employ our own methodology for clustering. So here is a clustering result. Let me hold on. Okay, so you can see there's a user John and Stephen Wang. They are on the same group and their group list is similar. So their cluster, the first cluster is based on the user DNA, and the second object is based on the group list, and the third object is based on their description. So combine them together, if they are the three cluster also the same object, they should be the similar object. So for example, like Stephen Wang and Jiang is a same in a same cluster. And if their permission are similar, they will nearby like less 10 and less 11. So I will ask the question for our GPT Han say, hold on. Let me check my, okay. Find the relay account with Jiang. Okay, it will operation about the CSV file and determine it to check the content of this CSV file. Oh, still working? Oh, hold on. It's my first time to do this live demo, so I'm not sure. Hope it's work. Hold on, it's index error. Okay, then. We can show you other demo later on, and maybe this CSV file has been break. And we have compared our real because we have doing over 20 domains and compare the human analysis result, and there's a accuracy of judgment is around 70%. So we find a similar account by the human analyst say this object is related to the other three user account. And we compare this clustering result is around the 70% currency. And there's a for remaining, you might ask the remaining around the 30%. How about the recent inconsistent classification? Because there's two kind of scenario. The domain size is too small. They're all only less than 1,000 user object. So they didn't have any management structure. They only put all the user in the same organization unit. And also the enterprise is well structured, and they have the AD three-tier manager model in their environment. So their organization unit is based on the tier 0 or tier 1 something like this. So all the user or all computer under the same organization unit, they are the business concept in the organization, not the permission on the active directory. So it's an unsatisfaction clustering result. And the third module is search sensitive information. So we want to search some sensitive information. Most common use case is about the password. So we do the, this is our real situation and we de-identify from the, de-identify it. And you can see there's some password on this screen. Maybe you can identify it. And you can check, check this out 10 seconds to find which of these are the, might be the password. If you are a human, you can very simple to identify the what is a possible password. But the following, if you want to do this by the programming method, actually it's very hard to write a regular expression about the what is password. Like for example, there's a similar like a possible password like the EAN at backup. There's a actually this kind of the password might be. So for the human, you can identify, oh, this is a possible password. But for the, you writing a regular expression, actually you can now write a real regular expression to extract this password too. And, so language model actually can help us identify the potential password, significantly reduce our human license effort. So we will output the information we want and ask the GPT to read the file and check which file might contain the password. Like this. So our goal is find sensitive data. So currently we are doing this about a password and the project name, something like this. Because sometimes we will want to know which project, maybe this VMware workstation or something like this. Maybe there's some workstation we want to target. So we might filter this out. But this challenge is about the length limitation. How about we overcome the length limitation? The first idea we pop out is there's a lot of the language model applications say this application can help you read the PDF file. And PDF file is a very large file, right? So how this kind of tool do is they are using the filter. So let's speed it to a chunk and the text to embedding and the use a filter store. So you can see this kind of graph. And if you input a text PDF and you will into the text and into a text to a different chunks and do the embedding model and store in the filter. When the user input the question, language model will extract a question and search in the filter store and find the reference data and answer you that question. So you can finally get an answer. This is a simple filter store. If you want to handle a large of the context, you might want to do this. But actually, we don't use this one. Because if we use this one, we might have lost some information in this kind of, this kind of method. So we just use a very simple one methodology. We just limit the input data. We limit it all to the JSON file and speed to the chunk and send to the language model one by one and store the result and finally ask the language model to read all the result and merge the result and output. So that actually there's quite a simple methodology. You don't need to use a filter because the filter might after you embedding, you might has lost some information you want. Now, here is a final part regarding of explanation about the attack path and the limitation. Here is user Jiang can control the key admins. He has a generic permission to key admins. So if you want to expand his attack path, And this the most important part is because we have multiple analysts. Maybe this analyzer and the second analyzer, they are different judgment. So we will have our own database to get all the analysts can copy the result, copy the limitation to avoid everyone has a wide different recommendation. So, but it still needs some human copy and paste. So we want to reduce this kind of error. So our goal is expand the specific test and get a property limitation. But this challenge is ChatGPT doesn't know too much about the security part. So if you just want ask hey, can you explain this path in English and give the two response to this attack path? And he's just giving us a very general result, say, oh, user Jiang has a generical permission to connect key admin. But it doesn't mention the impact or what we want to do. So we want to do the get impact and remediation. So before we ask the ChatGPT to do this kind of to achieve our goal. So we have some requirement for ourselves is anonymization. Because we want to send the attack path to the ChatGPT, that's a privacy issue. So we do the anonymization to de-identify the user object name. Because if you remove all the user object name, there's a John, there's a Stephen, like this, you remove all the object name, it can solve the privacy issue. And utilize the approved reference data because we have built our own database. I can show you later on. To avoid ChatGPT doesn't tell you something actually doesn't exist. And the comprehensive explanation so it can include the impact and the strategy of the mitigation. This is what we want. So based on this is our comprehensive explanation. So we have the description and remediation and the impact. CSV. So basically, you can see this on this slide, it's based on our own database is writing on the Mandarin. So I translate this to the English version, just let you guys can read. So when we doing this training, we pick our report writing in Mandarin. So we just use a Mandarin to ask the ChatGPT, say, oh, you help me write the report and just translate the result to the English version. So first, we will use the, we need to identify different relationship or different age. Like this permission is generical all. So we have what is a generical all? It's a full authority over the design object. It can control this object, the DSEL. And there's a remediation for you might be remove the access, something like this, or it's not required. Or if you want to just keep it, and like the impact part is, because the impact part is very important, is, if you have generated all to a computer, to a user, if you have a generated all to a user, you can reset the user password. But if you generate all to the group, it's not reset password things. It's about you can add a member to this group. So it's kind of a different impact. So that's why we will have a relation with the impact target with a different kind of a situation. So this just a simple demo about this one. And that's a GPT response for this kind of situation. And it's just very short, just a user to the key admin. So it's indicated the user object has a generical permission of a key admin. Allow him to control the member of the key admin. So it's recommended to verification if John has actually need this permission. So this is our whole system design, and we are going to the final demo part. So this is our goal. Our goal is our existing demo. I will show the find account with the plain text password in the description, and we find the account with the plain text description, plain text password in description, and we will find the attack path to the high value target and write a report. Okay, so first we want to ask the GPTHound, say, oh, write a cipher query, all the AD object has a description, exclude the MP data. And you can see it's a return the cipher query about the find the node where is object type, which is our Near4j Bloodhound database object type and overall object type, and find the user description. User description is not null, and return the value. And we want to execute this kind of command. And we have to write our another cipher query because every time he just responds a different cipher query. Basically, it's the same result, but we just want to make sure our demo is work. Okay, so it's said the result is sent in the template. So here is the query result. So you can see. Let me just. You can see there's some password, like the VDD, like the writing Chinese or writing in Japanese. Something like this. And then next. We will ask GPTHound to read this template JSON and check which might contain the password. I should require a bit. Yep. Here is the result. So maybe, and you can see there's some, like, he identified the different language, like the Japanese. And also, in this demo case, we want to target password like a string, like the fault CIP at the dollar sign. So we might find this object, so generate cipher query, which user contains in description. And it will give me the cipher query. And we can use this cipher query on the Bloodhound. And you can see there's a pretty classy, he has a description in this password like string, and we check this account might can get the high value target. So in this case, let me just zoom in the little bit. Okay. You can see this user account can generate all controller type AOU. And the type AOU contains an admin call 1221 DMD. After that, there's a Chinese is about the administrator. And this administrator can generate all to the key admins. So we want to write a report about this attack path, so we just explore our own cipher query. Hold on. So just like this, we can explore the different. So there's a KC user can generate all type AOU and contains this information and finally get a key admins. So I will ask hold on. Expand this attack path. Oh, I forgot that the object is plain in the English. Hold on. I have a cheat sheet. So it will get the CSV file contain our explanation and the edge impact, so it will get the final result. So it will choose the action calc from the craft format path explanation and input the information we require. And here comes the result. So here's our craft result is, let's say, user Brita Pretty KC has a generic permission to type all you can control this content. And it's kind of can control the 1221 admin to permission to the group control this content. And finally, so its recommendation is based on you might need to remove the permission on the all you. If not, the permission should is removed, and just check this out. And if it's just checking check the 1221 need to be in the OU Taipei, because sometimes in the remediation, we will not tell our customer to remove permission. Maybe it's remove the object in this OU. So it can avoid, if you want to keep the 1221 DMD admin in this permission to the key admins. So the methodology might be, the remediation policy might be the remove the KC object to the type AOU, or remove the 1221 admin from the type AOU, move to the other organization unit. And back into our site. And there's a conclusion. So there's a lot of many security issues in the Active Directory, and there's a lot of information needs to be memorizing. So we want to use the language model to as an assistance to accuracy about the efficiency of our analyst. And because the language model is very good suit as a handling task that don't require high precisely consumer of the analyzed energy. So for example, writing article, determining a similar text or passwords and likes is already language model good at it. And then you just need to prepare a reference material for the language model. Just don't rely this on he already know everything. Actually, it's not. So if you just tell him ChatGPT or our language model, tell him what you want, real desire, and he can really help you. And use a non-English non-English material as well, as this can also output final output to English. Still be expensive. And the final part is, the last is, we take a lot of time to adjust the prompt. Actually, you don't need to do this kind of thing. Just provide the reference data. If you take too much time to adjust the prompt, you may be, actually, maybe next generation language model, your prompt is not working. So don't waste time to adjust the prompt. Just to provide the reference data is more efficiency. And thank you.